So here's the thing with y'all, man. Celtics in six, blah, blah, blah. Well, that's a lot of hog shit. We should all just go ahead and squash that. Because if you know LeBron is 1-for-2 in this series, well, I mean, like, well, actually, in these playoffs, he's 1-for-2 in the playoffs in game one in these series, but he's seven for two after that. And even in his career, LeBron hardly ever wins game one. And he even said in a post-game interview that this is more a feel-out game for him. And even sports experts even tell you that game one is always a fill-out for LeBron. However, I will say this, though. The Cavs can lose this series if they go out 0-for-12 in the first half from the three-point line and 4-for-26 for the whole game. You know what I'm saying? And then J.R. Smith not stepping up playing defense, which I'm really getting tired of J.R. Smith, man. Like, this man is more inconsistent than, like, Donald Trump's administration. Like, you either gonna show up or you're not. I mean, like, no disrespect to my mans and all that, man, but you know what I'm saying? You can't go 0-for-4 from the first half, man, and then score only 4 points for the whole game.
Hell no!
Hey, man, like, that's not gonna take us nowhere. Hill, you gotta step it up. Tristan Thompson, bro, like, you still looking like Tristan Kardashian.
Damn!
You only give me 8 points. I see why Tyronn Lue is contemplating on starting you for game two, man, because that would just piss poor, man. Like you look more like Tristan Kardashian than Tristan Thompson. Like, I need him for game two, man. Like, leave that in Hollywood, bro. Like, in Cleveland, I need Tristan Thompson. But again, secondly, that's not detract from the point. The Celtics are a good team defensively. They have been all year, and we should not take that away from them. Jaylen Brown is one of the most outstanding rookies to come out of college, in my opinion. Rose doing his thing. Al Horford, for old big man, the man has high basketball IQ. Like, we can't take that away from him. So the Cavs can lose this series if they come out shooting 0-for-12 from the three in the first half, then going 4-for-26 and shooting less than 30% from the field, like LeBron, man, who went 5-16-15 points, which is one of his lowest scoring games since the 2011 series versus the Mavericks.
Why you bringing up old shit?
If y'all remember that, that's just, like, that's piss poor. You can't do that. Like, if you're one of the greatest basketball players in the game, we need to show up for that. Even though your record says different against the Celtics, man, like, this is a whole different time, man. Like, this is basketball. I mean, like, just because you had 6 days of rest, bro, don't mean you finna just come out and just start whooping on them, man. Because the Celtics defense was coming out, but talking about, yeah, we know you one of the greatest basketball players of all time, arguably. But we not finna let you come in here to Boston, where we're historically a home franchise team, with a good record at home, and just let you whoop on us like that, like you did against Toronto. And again, we, you know what I mean, like, Toronto is
garbage.
No, they done. But, you know what I'm saying? But, like, that, like, this is how the Cavs can lose this series. You know, like, playing piss poor like that, LeBron. But, I mean, even though LeBron finna get his, I mean, like, LeBron finna get you a triple-double. But for the rest of the team, bro, like, you need J.R. Smith to step it up. You need Tristan Thompson not to be Kardashian. You need him to be Thompson. You know what I'm saying? You need Grant Hill to step it up. You need that bench to step it up. You need Kevin Love to stay consistent with 17 to 20 points. You know what I'm saying? And not give you seven to 9 points a game like he did against Indiana.
What kind of shit is that?
And then all of a sudden want to come hard against the Raptors, man. Like, you need Kevin Love to stay consistent in this series for the Cavs to even have a chance of winning this. Yeah, so basically, like, we shouldn't take game one so serious as Celtics. You know what I'm saying? Even though they are collectively a good team defensively, they're a young, fast-paced team who can get it going if you let them, with Rose, Jaylen Brown, Horford, and, you know what I'm saying, and the rest of the crew. But, again, we should not be taking this so seriously.